Kiorana, Talofa Lava, and Happy New Year, and welcome to TP Plus, Tangata Pasifika's summer series. I'm Alistar Kata. Over the next half hour, I'll be chatting to our panel about our topic of the day, dating in the 21st century. How hard is it? Do apps help? Do we only connect online? Well, plenty to talk about here, guys. Joining me to pour their hearts out is Lavinia Uhila, who's waiting for Mr. Right.
Woohoo!
Johnson Raela, who's just happy to Netflix and chill.
Oh.
And she's looking for love, it's Josephine Bartley.
Thank you.
And finally, our very own John Pulu, who's...
Thank you very much. In love.
Thank you.
Oh, can wow, you two just get a room?
That's good. Great answer there. Kia ora, everybody. Thank you for joining us. But before we start, throughout the show, we'll be playing a game of Who Am I? We'll give you clues so you and our panellists can try and guess who our mystery Pacific person is. Here's our first clue. My name is the same as a Pacific Island's national flower and cultural festival. Oh, who could it be, guys? Ooh, bit of a tricky
a tough one.
Yeah.
Not really.
But not really? Or it might be too obvious.
I know it is, but it depends on what the prize is.
Nice. We'll save it for the end, save it for the end. We'll have more clues later and we'll see if our panellists can guess who it is. But first, let's get into the dating game. So, guys, there's so many ways to meet different people these days. How are we dating? What have you guys experienced?
Nothing. That's the problem.
But in all seriousness, yeah, how's it been for you?
Oh, it's just, it's like a drought out there, a desert.
Yeah.
It's just nothing. I don't know what it is, but, you know, I've tried the dating apps. Mm. You know, I'm on Tinder.
Mm.
And out of respect for the audience, I won't go on about what Tinder does or is, but
yeah,
that's not where you find a husband.
Right, gotcha. And for you guys?
Well, I'm not in a position to want to date. You know,
right.
I'm happy being single. I'm happy, you know, with my DMs being open. And people think that's still odd. But I'm unapologetic about it. And if anybody's got a problem, it's on them, not on me.
But the thing is, I know a lot of people who are more open these days. We're moving away from the traditional and more open into, no, you know what, I'm going to stay single for longer and that's okay.
Yeah.
For you, has it been the same, Lavinia?
Yeah, I think so. I know a lot of my friends and my cousins who are a little bit younger than me, they're all married now, have children, and I get the looks from the aunties going, come on, girl, your time's up soon. But I'm kind of in a place where dating is quite enjoyable because I'm older and I'm meeting quite a few different people, and it's fun. I think it's, I'm at a different stage, I guess, obviously, of life.
I think we should make more of an effort. In the Tongan culture, drinking kava was courting as well. So I would go to Star's house with a bowl of kava and we'd just sit there and start courting. No one's making the effort nowadays.
No, you haven't made the effort. Yeah. You haven't come to my house with a kava bowl.
I would love it if someone tuned up
with
a kava bowl.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
I would just love it.
Yeah, you know, you go the lengths to show your appreciation and you try and win them over.
But what about dating online? Have all of you tried, I mean, you've tried it, Josephine, you know, has it changed the game? What do you think about it? Is it weird?
It's weird, yeah.
It is.
It's weird. I tried group dating, so I went on a date with eight. You know, you just turn up to a venue, it's very James Bond.
Mm.
You turn up there, you tell them that you're here to meet Mr. Jones, and then you go to a table and there's eight of you, and you're total strangers.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you just get to know each other and, you know, no match, lace of luck, no fish, and you go
still
home.
Fishing, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you've tried online dating.
Yeah, well, I don't really consider it dating because, I mean, using Tinder, hence why I'm always overseas. Because, like, I love using Tinder overseas because I've seen it here being used here in New Zealand, and you're like, oh no, I know that person. Oh no, that person's supposed to be in a relationship.
Oh, my cousin.
Supposedly.
Yeah. So,
yeah, going over, I mean, I was in Fiji not too long ago, and I was surprised at how many, you know, beautiful young Fijian women, especially like native Fijian women, were on Tinder. And then you have, you have the tourists that are obviously just there to have some fun. And so, when it comes to dating, is that dating? I don't think so. For me, it's just having some fun.
Right, having a good time.
And I'm always upfront about that.
Yeah.
Like, just as long as you're upfront about what you want, then...
As long as you're on the same page, then everyone's in understanding. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But then what about being catfished? Is the worry that you'll be duped over by someone? Or have you been catfished before?
No, I haven't been catfished. I mean, I have shown up to meet somebody, and then their photo may have been 10 years ago. like that's been the case, but after a few drinks, it doesn't really matter.
And it's, wow. It's really hard online because you don't really know who you're talking to on the other side.
That's exactly it.
And that's why I always insist, I mean, I watch, but I always insist on like a video call, just to, you know, to see if they're real.
Just to verify that it's a person.
Or if they're just a scammer, trying to rip you off, because, you know, we don't fall for that whole.
And what if they avoid the video call?
Well, then you know it's a scam. Yeah. And so you just don't bother.
Yeah.
I'm actually quite open to the idea as well of some of our traditions where the man comes over to your house and he asks permission from your parents to date. Like, that's quite common. I'm noticing some of those traditions are still happening nowadays. But, yeah, I'm all about face-to-face. Let's connect. Let's see if we have chemistry. If not, then, yeah. But
very good answer. I agree with you. I can't do online dating. I think it's so weird.
I can do emails, but that's probably it.
Well, if I could share a story about the last date that I did go on, and it was set up through friends, and I went to go and pick her up, and she came in the car, righty, righty, rah. To cut a long story short, after a couple of dates, I said to her, look, this is, for me, it's not really going anywhere, if I'm going to be honest with you. Really, I just, you know, probably should have been straight up right from the start. And then the first thing she said to me was, oh, yeah, I didn't think it was going to work out because you didn't open the car door for me.
Yeah.
Wow. Red flag. Like, red flag right there.
Well, for me, I was like, but you forgot about all the 10 restaurant doors I opened for you. And you remembered about that. And speaking to other friends about it, they have even said that, you know, that lots of ladies look for that.
A gentleman.
I'm still a gentleman, but
yeah, just in a different way.
I didn't really think about that.
KFC, BMW.
Well, thank you for that, guys. We're going to move on. You talk to some people out there on the street, JP.
Absolutely, thank you, Alistair. I've been out and about, and here's what people had to say about dating and romance and love, etc.
With media and social media platforms, there are different ways of actually looking for love. And I think it just comes down to the individual in terms of what they're actually looking for and what drives that and their values.
At the end of the day, I think it's more face-to-face. Like, as much as we want to like message people on social media, there's just so many times where you could be catfished.
Just getting to know someone first before, you know, finding love. And hopefully you'll find a match.
Malo lele, whakalofalahi atu, and welcome back to TP Plus, Tangata Pasifika's summer series. Today we're talking dating in the 21st century with our panel, but first, here's the second clue for our Who Am I mystery person. I played Leilani in Sione's wedding. Okay, I think it's pretty obvious, don't you think? Don't say it yet, don't say it. I know you're all burning to get it out.
That's really tough. Yeah. Do I win $1 million if I get it right?
I'm really sorry about that, you just win me. Okay, guys, we'll reveal who our mystery person is at the end of the show. Right now, it's back to our panel. So, guys, we are talking about dating. We're moving away more and more from the traditional. Is this true for you guys and what you guys are doing now in your lives?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, unfortunately, that seems to be the way of things, you know. I got some interesting pictures, private messages to me on Facebook, totally unsolicited, but apparently that's the way to communicate, you know. Yeah. And I went back and I was like, you know, you could have just sent me a picture of your face.
So, okay, moving right along here. It's a very, very untraditional way. But, I mean, you were saying before how you like the traditional sense of things. Do you think there's young people that still want to hold on to the culture?
It's mixed, I think. Some that probably have been more exposed to it as they were growing up, for example, within the church or within the community, they probably would be a little more open to it. Mm. But obviously our generation, X, Y, Z, social media, all the other different influences play a big part in that. But you just got to move with the changes, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Is arranged marriage traditional?
Yeah, I mean, is that a thing now?
I'm not a fan of arranged marriages.
But I know some of my friends have had arranged marriages, though, you know, so I know it's still a thing, but it's very old school, isn't it? Mm. Yeah.
Yeah, well, see this thing around marriage and when you when you look at, when you go and discuss with your family, especially Pacific families, you know, all of a sudden you're in your 30s and they look at you like, so where are your children?
Yeah,
and
then, that's me, everyone.
And then they start, you know, they start questioning your sexuality, they start questioning all these different things about you. And for me, I'm quite open with my family. Now they don't even ask me anymore, but around the fact that I'm actually happy being by myself.
And they're okay with that?
Yeah, well, now they're okay, but some people still don't understand that you can actually spend some time with yourself, and that's actually quite cool. It's actually a way to recharge, but...
I've done that for 17 years. I'm ready for a boyfriend now.
Woo!
Actually, I'm ready for a husband.
Let's get it, Josephine.
That's why I applied to Married at First Sight, because I'm going to do it. I'm gonna, I hope to get on it, because I like the idea of, you know, people vetting someone for me, and there's someone out there just for me. So my girlfriends, they bought me a diamond ring for my 40th because they love me and I love them, but they also were like, oh, it's not likely that you're going to get a diamond ring.
Wow.
So we'll get it for you.
You show them.
Yeah.
show them.
But, you know, I'm going to get it.
Yeah, and on that note, you signed up to Married at First Sight for the New Zealand version. Are you scared of putting your sort of life, your heart out there, wearing a heart on your sleeve? Is that, does that scare you?
Absolutely, absolutely. It scares me because it's not the traditional way of finding someone. And even trying to tell my mum that I did it, so I told her during a funeral.
So
she couldn't.
I know, but it's definitely different. Not all my family know yet, but they're going to because it's on Facebook. Mm. But I'm just wishing for the best.
Yeah.
Wishing for the best.
See, that's why the thing is that dating knows no age range.
Right.
Like, who said dating is for a certain age bracket? Like, and I love that, and I commend you on that, and, you know, massive big ups for taking that leap of faith, and hopefully out of this show, maybe they might come forward and you won't have to make it to Married at First Sight. But
Josephine, sorry, there's a group of men lining up outside. Oh, no, sorry, that's the next neighbour's house. Sorry.
That's
sorry.
KFC's got a special on. That's where they really are. There's no Tongans lining up with kava bowls for me.
Don't worry, Josephine. Yeah, cool. We'll find them. Absolutely. Please, yeah, please. Commend you. But the other thing I want to talk about is people are staying, younger people are staying single for longer. Mm. Is that something that you guys agree with? Is there pressure from your parents to get married? What is going on in your guys' lives?
Well, definitely for my age group and the girls that I know, they're definitely enjoying their single life and really mastering that space. And I think that's just an opportunity to get your career sorted. They want to just get to know themselves and be comfortable with who they are. Yeah. And then when they're ready, they'll settle. And I think, it's just...
I think a lot of people want to do the whole career thing before settling down. You know, they want to see the world and do things like that before they settle down and have 1 million children, so...
I'll admit it, I'm a workaholic.
Yeah.
And I love it. I love working.
And it's that lifestyle as well, you know. Yeah. You can't go with children and your work.
That's why you take work trips.
Go to Australia.
But then with that, is there the fear of being alone then? Like, is there the fear that you've missed the boat if you don't get into the dating game sooner and focus on your career?
If I'm going to be honest with you, for me, the fear of being alone doesn't worry me right now. Maybe I'll deal with that later down the track, but we'll deal with that when that happens.
I'm later down the track. That's why I'm being random and going on a TV show to get a husband.
Resorted to that,
And if that doesn't work, then I'm going to go get 10 cats, bottle of vodka.
I love that.
That's my life.
How much of finding love is a priority for you guys? We know it's like priority for you because you've gone and signed up for a show. Is it priority for anyone else, your friends, yourselves?
No.
Yeah. I could have guessed that before I asked. And why?
Well, it's, you know, and that's not to say that I don't believe in love, because I definitely believe in love. I've seen love, beautiful love in action, my parents, my best friends, and, you know, I know it exists. Mm. But I'm too selfish and I want all my money to myself.
And that's the other thing, relationships comes with money. Yep. You know, you have to spend...
Amen. Amen, praise the Lord, Jesus.
Corner over there.
Jesus, take the wheel, please.
Is it a priority for you?
I think the priority for me is just to be patient and then trusting that the process will... that he will come and then that love will just...
Did you say persons? Is it
going to be...
Sorry. Hearing problem on this.
Don't worry about that side.
Just waiting.
Just waiting. Willing to wait for the right person. That's awesome.
Waiting to exhale. I mean, you need the asthma pump because you hold your breath for too long.
Just don't go and burn the car, eh, when it doesn't work.
Well, thanks for that, guys. Really awesome stories. JP, what did everyone think out there?
Love, love, love. It's a beautiful topic. Here's what people had to say.
I guess it just depends on what you grew up with. So I'm not used to, like, all the dating sites and that, even though I tried it. And, yeah, but, yeah, so that was really uncomfortable for me. But, like, it's quite normal for a lot of my friends.
Well, as far as I know, love is we have to get to know the person very well, know likes and dislikes.
Vanaka, everybody. Welcome back to TP Plus, Tangata Pasifika's summer series. Today we're talking about dating in our panel discussion, but first here's our last clue to identify our Who Am I mystery person. Oscar Kightley is my bestie.
Ooh.
Right, well, that's pretty obvious by now, isn't it? Yes, you all got it in your heads.
I still don't know.
If you still don't know, then really, you need help. Well, the big reveal will happen soon, but right now it's time for our panel discussion. So what are we looking for when it comes to love, guys? Lavinia?
I think for me, someone who shows affection, so who's willing to be able to be vulnerable and sensitive to me, but also someone who is loyal, likes to have fun, and also a great communicator as well, because I think communication is key.
Yeah, communication's like number one for most girls, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
For you, Johnson?
If I was looking for love.
But that's a good point. Are you looking for love?
No.
Yeah.
No, I'm not. And there's nothing wrong with it. Mm. But, you know, I would like to think that for those, you know, when I look at examples of love, honesty, a caring heart, but also, you know, a willingness to understand that it's not just about you anymore. Because I'm still at that stage where it's just about me.
Mm.
And so it's not just about you. You've got to care about this significant other. But what comes with that is their family and, you know, the moulding of two families if it eventually gets to that stage. So it's not all about you when it comes to love.
Hmm? You, Josephine? Obviously.
I didn't ask for much in my application video for Married at First Sight. I said, look, you know, a good guy who's got a job and his own set of teeth. But then people started calling me a teethist. And I don't know what that is, so now I'm going to ease off on that, you know? Like,
that's so okay. Mean, Josephine. What is going on here, Josephine?
So I was like, oh, geez, really, PC. So actually, I'm looking for an equal. I'm looking for someone that will, you know, share my life with me, can make me laugh, has got a good heart, understands community, you know, patient, loyal.
Yeah.
All
those
family,
good qualities.
All those good qualities that you would get from a reality TV show.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so we've
kept tabs on that, though.
We've sat here and talked about dating and love and this, and I know you're asking us about our expert opinion in dating, but you're throwing subliminals across the table here. And, you know, the three of us, you know, look at your own experiences of dating each other, if you're willing to talk about that.
Oh,
you know?
Absolutely. The thing that I like about John and I is we understand each other's schedules. We do the same job, and so it's really easy to get along with each other. Oh, but we've been friends for ages. We met, and I think that's really important.
We met at university, because Star used to...
friends first,
yeah.
Right?
Star used to copy my answers at university. Yeah. That's why she failed.
You know that's a lie, but...
But that's exactly it. People say that actually friendship, out of friendship comes love.
Yeah, and also he makes me laugh. Well, he makes everyone laugh, but, you know, me mostly.
But you have to say that.
Yeah. Yeah, but other thing that I want to know is, do you guys believe in one person for the rest of your lives? Because I know a lot of my friends are saying now, nah, I don't really believe that. I don't believe there should be one person, one soulmate. What do you guys think?
I think more for me that my view is... you are making a commitment to that person, so that is important for you to stay with that person for the longevity of that journey, flaws and all. Yeah, so that's
like
how
that.
I view it.
See, that's really romantic, hey? That's like what a romantic would say.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you believe in one person for the rest of your life?
So that's
if you go back to his initial answer, the DTF.
Well, you see, I like try before you buy. So,
Will you get to a point though where you're like, that's the one that I want to spend the rest of my day to grow old with? You know, will you get to that point, do you think?
You know, I don't know. I can't answer that right now. And, you know, to be completely honest, I, I just don't know. But I know that it's possible.
Yeah.
And you know what? Tomorrow I might wake up and be like, okay, let's change the story now. But no, at this point, I'm happy, you know? Because at the end of the day, as long as I'm happy, then I'm fine with it.
Yeah, exactly. As long as you're happy and you're good with that, then, you know, what else matters? Yeah. You, Josephine, you obviously...
I absolutely believe in love and soulmates. I mean, you know, you look at all those people, like my parents' generation, they only married once.
Beautiful.
You know, and then when my dad died, my mum has never gone out with anybody else. There's been nobody else since my dad. And I just, you know, that's so beautiful, but it's also, you know, really sad because they would want that person to be happy again and find love again. So, yes, I believe in soulmates, but I really hope that there's more than one out there for people.
Yeah,
it's beautiful.
Yeah, really beautiful. Well said.
Thank you.
Well, guys, this has been truly, truly fun, honestly. But now it's time to reveal our Who Am I mystery guest. We're going to give our panel 5 seconds to write their answers on the cards in front of them. Go for it, guys. But before we reveal our answers here, JP, did anyone out there on the street get it right?
Yes, thank you very much, Alistar. I've been giving people the same clues, and this is what they had to say.
I don't know.
Is it Tuila Blakely?
Very nice. Let's find out what our guests, who do you think the mystery person is?
Oh. Go, who is it?
It was so hard.
1, 2, 3, go.
Go, reveal.
Well, I forgot what the clues were.
But you were just thinking of her.
This is, you know, if I ever was going to fall in love.
JP?
I'm very happy to announce that you lovely ladies have got the correct answer.
Yes.
Johnson, I'm afraid you're going home tonight.
Sorry, Take Johnson. Sorry. You've been eliminated from the dating show.
Give me your phone.
Good, all this talk about love is making me sick.
Oh, well, thank you so much, guys. Well, that's the end of this week's panel. Thank you to all of our guests. Join us again next week for another TP Plus panel, our topic, beauty pageants. How relevant are they today? Well, thank you for joining us and staying with us. Hope you're enjoying your holidays. Ka kite.